40 games. One weekend, one aim. To achieve foot champions success. And only one man holds the key to said success. And his name, Glenn Murray. How's it going, guys? And welcome to episode 1 of my Foot Champions Weekend League run on my Man Like Murray account. And in today's episode, we'll be playing the first 8 games of the Foot Champions Weekend League, as well as showing you the squad I used in the Weekend League, and then at the end of the episode, I'll put a compilation of 10 games I played in the build-up to this recording to get me prepared and to build up some extra coins. Now, as we take a look at the squad, you'll see in goal we have Jack Butland, who'd been very reliable for us in our English side, so I thought he'd do a good job in this team. We have a back four of Antonio Valencia, Chris Smalling, Virgil van Dijk and Danny Rose, who are all very solid defenders in this game. In the defensive midfield we went for height, so we went with Marouane Fellaini as I was sure he'd win all the defensive headers. As the two centre mids we went with Moussa Dembele of Spurs and Emre Can of Liverpool. Now, linking up the whole team in the cam position, we had Adam Lallana, who's got 4-star skills and 5-star weak foot, and amazing dribbling, so I knew he'd be a great use to us. And up top, we had the main man, Glenn Murray, and we also had the second in form, Dwight Gayle, who might I say has some unbelievable stats for an 81 overall. And he's the main bulk of the coins. Of my 50,000 coins, I spent most of it on him. And we also got Seydou Doumbia on the bench to be the super sub. Now, going into the first game, we come up against a very solid Premier League side with Anthony Martial, man of the match Walcott, and Heung-min Son. And we start things off with a bang as Dwight Gayle smashes the ball on his left boot from just inside the box into the top corner of the net in the 7th minute, giving us a 1-0 lead and getting us off to a very promising start in Foot Champions. Now, in Foot Champions, I always like to start with a win, as I feel it gets me off the bat well, and I always go on a good run of form if I get a win in my first game. And we weren't done there, as Glenn Murray shows why he is the man we built this series around, as he finesses the ball into the bottom corner from just outside the box, giving us a 2-0 lead inside 18 minutes, and pretty much putting this game to bed before it had really had a chance to start. And Glenn Murray showing that he is up to the standard of Foot Champions, which might I say is a very high standard, and many players that are good for you in divisions just don't live up to the quality of Foot Champions, but Glenn Murray is not one of those players. Now, we completely put the game to bed in the 79th minute as Dwight Gayle manages to pick up a rebound, giving us a 3-0 lead. And at this point, my opponent had no way back into this game, so he decided to turn off his Xbox, giving me my first win and giving him his first loss, and I'll take it. It's an excellent start for us. Now, going into our second game, I could not believe what we'd been matched up against. This has to be one of the best Premier League sides I've seen all FIFA. And unsurprisingly, his right forward Mané, who's got 99 pace, would cause us a lot of problems in this game, as he puts a ball low into front post, which takes an unfortunate deflection off Van Dijk, giving them a 1-0 lead. He would then sweat the ball across the box with Mané, and would find Heung-min Son, who would give him a 2-0 lead just before half-time. But as always in this series, we have an answer, and Glenn Murray absolutely rifled the ball from just outside the box with so much power that he found the top corner, beating my opponent's goalkeeper, and putting us right back into this match just before the half-time break. And up until this point, I hadn't had much going for me in this match, but this goal gave me a lot of confidence, as it reduced the deficit to just one goal. And that one goal deficit wouldn't last for long, as Dwight Gayle goes through on goal just after half-time and chips the goalkeeper, making it 2-2 and levelling up the match. And I really hadn't deserved this, but I've got two top-quality strikers who are excellent at putting away all their chances, and so they have in this game. My opponent gave me two half-decent chances, and I've scored them both. And somehow, I don't know how, we make it 3-2, in a game where the only shot we had in the first half was that goal from Glenn Murray. And somehow, in the second half, things turned, things changed. I don't know what it was, but this game had completely turned around from him dominating me to me dominating him. And Dwight Gayle gives us the lead for the first time in this match, putting us 3-2 up in our second game in Foot Champions. And we weren't done there, as the ball's whipped into Gayle, who has an easy header into the back of the net, putting us 4-2 up and pretty much putting the game to bed, although I knew my opponent would still be dangerous with the quality of players he had. And it was an excellent cross from Moussa Dembélé to set Dwight Gayle up with an open goal to head the ball into. But unsurprisingly, my opponent wasn't done there, as Mané manages to get through on goal and plays it across to Son again, who slots the ball away, making it 4-3, and things were looking dangerous, but I wasn't worried because I knew my team had the quality to score another goal and finish this game, and so they would, as Dwight Gayle whips the ball into the box and Glenn Murray meets it on the half volley in the 89th minute to make it 5-3 and give us an excellent win and an excellent comeback against an excellent side. And I was so impressed with how this team was playing at this point. Like, I had a very slow start in the first game, but once I started getting my goals, things were looking good and the team's continued its form over to the second match. And we now progress into Bronze 2 by getting 2 wins out of our first 2 games in Foot Champions. Now, of all the teams I came up against, this one had scared me the most, because 5 at the back teams are always dangerous. But Dwight Gayle, who's been unbelievable in this team, shows his quality again as he finesses the ball into the back of the net past the goalkeeper. And if you guys have an English team and have 30,000 coins lying around, pick him up. He is stupidly good. Now, my opponent would level things up for a really unlucky rebound for me, as Jack Butland did well to get to the first shot, but did poorly to deflect it back to him. And he would then take the lead straight after, as Jordan Ayew finds the back of the net with a good finish. He then manages to out-strengthen my player with Willian and make it 3-1 in the game, pretty much putting this match to bed before it had a chance to start. But as always, in this series we had an answer. Gayle puts a ball into front post, which takes a deflection, but then Chan lays it off to Van Dijk, who finishes the ball very nicely into the bottom corner of the net, making it 3-2 and putting us back into this game. And it was very hard attacking against this guy because of his 5 at the back, and for most of this game he was playing on Park the Bus. Now, unfortunately, he would make it 4-2 in the 63rd minute with Ilkay Gundogan and pretty much put the game to bed. And he added insult to injury as he made it 5-2 in the 81st minute. And at this point, I knew there was no way back into this game. This guy had played defensive counter-attack and it had worked well for him, and we take our first loss in the Foot Champions Weekend League. Now, when we look at the team of my next opponent, we see that we've come up against yet another 5-back side, and my opponent would take the lead in this game as he plays the ball across the box, as people like to do in Foot Champions, to Juan Cuadrado, who makes things 1-0. But we manage to level things up in this game as we play a through ball to Dwight Gayle, who runs through on goal, beats his man, and finesses the ball on his left boot into the top corner past the goalkeeper. And what an excellent finish on his weak foot. This guy's finishing is unbelievable. You should really pick him up if you have an English or a Championship side. He put it so well in the corner, the keeper had no chance. Now, unfortunately, my opponent would make it 2-1 right from kickoff, as Ivan Perisic smashes the ball from outside of the box into the back of the net, and my opponent wasn't done there, as Mauro Riccardi puts him 3-1 up and pretty much puts this game to bed in the first half. But as always, we had an answer, and Glenn Murray makes it 3-2 right before the half-time break, putting us right back in the game, just as he did in that other match that we came back into. And it was an excellent finesse shot from where he was, with just enough power and the perfect amount of curve to beat the goalkeeper. And always, in this series, I don't know what it is, we always have an answer to everything. And yet again, Glenn Murray is the man. He draws us level in this game, making it 3-3. And I thought Murray would be okay in Foot Champions. He's been excellent in Divisions, but Foot Champions is just that level higher. But Glenn Murray's almost playing better in Foot Champions than he does in Divisions for us. It's ridiculous. And we level up a game that we were well behind in, and we weren't done there. Adam Lallana plays the ball over the top to Dwight Gayle, who finishes the ball, as he always has done for us, giving us a 4-3 lead in a game that we were 3-1 down in. And it's safe to say, in Foot Champions, we are the comeback kings. We've had two incredible comebacks already, and we're only just getting started. And if this doesn't make these next few videos look good, then what's going to? Like, we just have such entertaining games in this series, and we pick up our third win in 4 games. Now we come up against a very solid looking side, and you see he has a lot of gold Foot Champions cards, which shows he's a good player, and he'd take a lead through Inaki Williams, who makes it 1-0 with a header in the first half. He'd then double his lead as he wins the ball back off our defender, and Luis Suarez puts it in the back of the net, and we pick up our second loss of the series so far, making us 3-2 on our record. And that was unfortunate, because we didn't really stand much of a chance against this guy. And whilst we're on the subject of not standing much of a chance, we get matched up against this guy with his ridiculous side. And somehow we'd take the lead in this match, as the ball gets in the back of the net from a lucky deflection from the keeper, as Dwight Gayle gives us a 1-0 lead. And I believe it's deserved luck, considering the golfing class between the two sides. We deserved a bit of luck in this match, and there it was. Now, unfortunately, Luis Hernandez's class would shine through as he slides the ball into the back of the net, levelling the game up and putting my opponent right back into this. And to be honest, this didn't surprise me that much. Although we would take the lead in this game as his two defenders run into each other and Moussa Dembélé pounces on the opportunity, giving us a 2-1 lead against a very good side in a game that we really didn't deserve to be 2-1 up in. But I felt like we were riding our luck and we were doing well. Although this guy would level things up as the ball falls to Gattuso, who slots the ball away well past the goalkeeper, making it 2-2 in the match. And my opponent wasn't done there, as he plays a through ball to Dele Alli, who slots it under the goalkeeper, making it 3-2 and securing the win for my opponent in a game that we didn't really stand a chance from the start. Now in our next match, we come up against yet another ridiculous legend in Mark Overmars, who has loads of pace and 5-star weak foot. And unsurprisingly, my opponent would take the lead through Overmars as he goes 1-0 up inside 6 minutes. And things weren't looking good at this point as he doubles his lead through Griezmann. And it was looking as if we were going to go on a loss streak, which is really not what you want this early on in Foot Champions. So I really wanted to turn it around. And then we get matched up against this. I absolutely hate playing 5-at-the-back teams, and this guy was no different to any of those others, as he gets a lucky header over my goalkeeper, giving him a 1-0 lead in this game. And he wasn't done there, as Samuel Eto'o goes through on goal and slots the ball away, making it 2-0 and putting this game to bed, and putting us on a 3-loss streak going into the end of this episode, which is really disappointing. Although that's where I'm going to end it. I want to thank you guys for watching. Please like, comment and subscribe for more Man Like Murray Foot Champions on my channel. And I'll leave you guys with a goal compilation of the 10 games I played in the build up to this episode. Till I get up, time is barely on our side. I don't wanna waste what's left. The storms we chase are leading us, and love is all we'll ever trust. Yeah, no, I don't wanna waste what's left. And on we'll go through the wastelands, through the highways, till my shadow turns to sun rays. And on we'll go through the wastelands, through the highways. And on we'll go.
turns to sun rays, and the
try, but you never.